Okay, there we are again, another video talk, this time about shifting values in our world, in our society, and how this relates to marketing, to management. So really, shifting values, where the default value of our lives more and more is just one word, value. Interesting enough, I mean, but what are values? Well, values are drivers, energetic drivers, and aspirations, intentions that we all have. A short way to describing a value and values, you know, our individual collective motivations that actually are important to us. Technology and is helping, this technological convergence that we have in our world is actually helping and affording a lot of interactions between, you know, context, between content and between the social relationships. Consequently, the issue about perceived value, value perceptions are in a constant flux of change and perpetual flux. What we need to recognize is there is not a deficit in data, my God, huge amount of terabytes. We are actually moving towards, we actually have yottabytes, which means, you know, 10 raised to the power of 21 zeros. But it's not to recognize that there is a deficit in data collection or even analytics. But there is definitely a deficit in insight to be able to make up what lies behind the data, what we can extract of meaningful explanation about what lies inside the data. But also shifting values, and this talk addresses the issue about shifting values, because we are actually shifting the way we think. Our system is coming under enormous stress. I mean, especially now with last 5 months with COVID-19, but clearly the old priorities are rejected and we have a new improved approach that has to be adopted. Financial metrics are balanced with those better and better reflecting society's needs, values around health, happiness and well-being. And of course, from a marketing point of view, the only value that the company will ever create is the value that comes from customers, from stakeholders and from society, but customers as well, stakeholders and from the employees as well. I'll come back to that. But it looks that we are missing the notion of value. There is a huge amount of value gaps and we need to readdress that imbalance. We, you know, we need really to have enlightened managers, marketers that should collaborate with consumers and to create a brain-to-brain dialogue, intelligent dialogue that will actually enhance value for both parties, both sides. We need really fairer exchanges. We need fairer management, fairer marketing. But what is an emotional value? Well, an emotional value is the economic value, or if you want, a monetary worth of feelings when the consumer perceives in a positive way or a negative way products, experience derived from products and services. So emotional value is much of any other attribute of the product, like quality, distribution, availability, etc., needs to be addressed. And is really, you know, the issue about value can really make or break a business. So the issue about the emotional design is critical for management in the future. And I can guarantee that tomorrow that either companies, marketing, products, brands deliver value through every interaction or is totally, they are totally ignored. People and society, consumers, they want value. They want perceived value. And if you don't have perceived value, as much as you spend in advertising or brand building, that you will be ignored. So, I mean, you know, you'll be totally ignored if you fail to deliver value at every interaction. In fact, more than that, you need to have a purpose. You need to align the values of the consumers with the values of your own brand, of your own organization. And to have a purpose is crucial. And there are studies, you know, with more than 3,000 consumers, others, more than 32,000 consumers, meaningful brands, that actually come up with lots and lots of findings. And I can tell you as well that companies that provide value compared to the ones that do not provide value, they can actually beat those companies in the stock market with indices probably about 133% higher than the ones that are just common run of the mill. It is important as well to have long-term value sharing within the company. Very, very important with your employees. Everybody has the purpose should be distilled inside the company, and the employees should be part. So a philosophical approach that has practical implications. A reflection of a partnership, a true relationship partnership with your employees, because everybody within the company makes and creates that value. So it's a kind of a wealth multiplier effect inside the company. Your employees, they need to tie the employees to your vision of delivering value and to be a growth plan for your company. And this is interesting because nowadays there's an emergence of, I spoke as well in a separate talk about marketpreneurs. A number of catalysts is like, you know, if you look at these major companies, they all started in a garage. The concept, you know, of a garage. The garage is back. Nowadays can actually go to the bedroom lab. But all the companies like Amazon, Mattel, Disney, everybody knows, Apple, Harley-Davidson, Google, they start in a garage. So the issue about business colonies, self-managing teams, decentralizing the company, breaking into parts, give them empowerment, ground up sort of motivation ideas, the emergence of catalysts, and that is very, very important. So companies have been shackling innovation, and now this is a way to unleash that very innovation spirit. Very, very important. And more than that, consumer value is not controlled through communication, advertising, brand building, price points. Is providing true consumer value. And that is the answer to any strong brand, clearly. So we need to use as well these transformation technologies to provide their value, not to impinge or to impose value, which is artificial, but really to create value for consumers in their own lives. New ways to serve human beings and the brand and the organization and the company. So, I mean, you know, consumer value not control is really the answer to strong brands. But more than that, we're talking about brain value. You have enormous amount of models dealing with brand valuation. But look at that. Consumers are becoming more and more knowledgeable, more savvy. They know what lies behind the brand. They are more educated, discriminating, demanding. They use prosumption, co-creation. They are transhumers. They lead transient lifestyles. So really, companies and brands, they need to take a different approach. And that different approach. So it's not really just, you know, brand value in terms of brand building. No, it's brain value. It's to have dialogues, intelligent dialogues with consumers, with stakeholders, with society. Brain to brain, that is important beyond really just the notion of consumer value and much beyond the notion of brand value. And of course, just to finish this short talk on shifting values, real value. What is real value? Well, lives that are changed, relationships that are sustained, challenges that are met, and goals that are achieved and reached. That is really real value. Thank you so much for being here with me.